episode 2992, How to Move Forward.
Moms, it's time to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew who you are in mind, body, and spirit. Welcome to Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, the show to help you do just that. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop sign,
watching people drive by. Happy, happy day. I hope you're ready for something extraordinary to happen. It's Mindset Monday, and yes, you need to get on with what you want to do with your dreams, your goals, what you're going after. It's no longer time to stay stuck. It's time to learn how to move forward. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already haven't had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com, where you can learn more and sign up for the K.I.S.S. newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by AIM, Inspiring Connection and Community. All right, so you want to know a secret? I have been off the mainland. Yes, I've been spending time with my mom, my sister, and my brother and my niece in Hawaii. Yes, aloha. I'm so excited just to be able to come back home a little bit and really just kind of get back to some of my roots where I grew up. And yes, I moved around in between, but really Hawaii is my home. And it's just so nice to get away. And sometimes we need to take that time to get away, to figure out what is the next step, where are we going. So today, I really wanted to talk to you about how to move forward. Because I believe we're putting a lot of our dreams on hold. We just sit there and we say, you know what, this doesn't really make sense right now. We blame it on the kids because they're too young. We blame it on the money because we don't have enough. We blame it on our house because, well, it's not big enough. Whatever it is you're blaming it on, we're going to drop the excuses. We're going to learn how to move forward. Because when you're feeling lost or unsure about what to do next in life, right, you got to figure a way to move forward. And that feeling, though, I want you to understand, is a common experience. Whether you're facing a major decision, a personal crisis, or simply feeling stuck, it can be difficult to know how to move forward. But there are things you can do to regain your sense of direction and take control of your life. What you can control. Not trying to control somebody else, right? Remember, I'm over here with my family. Family, right? You let it all hang out. Sometimes there are things in life that you have to realize what you can't control and focus on what you can control. So when you think about what you need to be doing, it's easy to stay hunkered down and not do anything. That leads you where? To those excuses of saying, oh, I'm playing the blame game. Blame it on the kids. It'd be nice because they blame it on us, right? Wouldn't it be nice just to blame everything on them? It doesn't work that way. That's not realistic. Maybe ideally in your head, you're like, yeah, I can reason with that. But if you really want to move forward, what do you do when you don't know what to do? Well, you got to hit the ground running. That is your KISS to Keep It Simple strategy. Hit the ground running. And I know it's hard, right? Because right now I have got so much on my plate right now. I have got kids going every which direction. I'm going every which direction. We're doing some things differently with Create Your Now. We're doing some experimentations, which takes a lot of energy and a different kind of effort. And we're also trying to figure out, does this work? And then I'm doing things with my family. I'm over here in Hawaii. And that's wonderful, but I'm on a totally different time zone in the middle of the ocean, of which I would love to stay all the time. But that really does throw my whole routine off. Now, I could have sat here and said, you know what, over the last week, I really didn't have time to talk to you guys. But I made time, even if it was just for a few moments, because I care about you, right? You're part of my family. And just because I'm away from my immediate family and I'm spending time with my, well, they are my immediate family, but you know what I mean? My own kids, my own husband, my extended family, my mom, my siblings, I still want to put in the work for you. And so I show up. But I could have decided, you know what, I'm going to live in the excuse of, I'm just tired. I have so much to do, and this energy level is just not there. Why? I mean, a lot of it is the time zone. And it's a little bit later posting. Have you noticed? It's not coming out as early as it normally does. And that's not because I don't want to talk to you. but it's because, well, really, the time just doesn't work. And so I'm doing what I can do. Now, I could have thrown up my hands in the air and said, I'm not doing this. But I chose not to. I would rather come, give you my thoughts, and say, you know what? I'm still thinking about you. Because I know in everyday life, right, we have to make decisions. And those decisions as to what we do next means we have to figure a way to take that next step, how to move forward. So let's look at a few ways we can learn, or I should say really a few ways that we can move forward. Number one, take a step back in order to move forward. And when you do that, you're reflecting, right? When you're feeling lost, it's important to take that step back and reflect on what's going on. Give yourself some time and space to think about what's causing your uncertainty. Write down your thoughts and your feelings in a journal. Talk to a trusted friend or even a family member. Or if you need to, reach out to a therapist or a counselor. When you gain some clarity on your situation, you'll be better equipped to make a plan for moving forward. A lot of times, we're just looking at this little moment, this little blip in the radar. Guess what? Your kids are only young for a very short period of time. But a lot of us write off our goals and our dreams because of our kids. And so then when it comes time, 10, 15 years later, and there's a little different space in your routine and in your life, in the season that you're in, guess what? Wait, I can start living out my dreams and readdressing them and start thinking about them. And now what's happened? You have forgotten about them. You really didn't do anything to either kind of keep your foot in the door or figure out, yeah, this is what I want to do. I'm just not going to do it now. So take a step back, right? So you can move forward and reflect. Number two, break things down into smaller pieces. Why are you trying to eat the whole elephant? Well, I wouldn't recommend you eat the whole elephant, but you know how that saying goes. So if you're feeling overwhelmed by the big picture, try breaking things down into smaller, more manageable sized pieces. Can you tell I've been on the island a little bit too much? This is real and raw. I'm telling you, I'm not going to edit. I just want to be here for you. So if I'm a little bit tongue-tied, it's honestly because, well, I should be in bed right now. But I'm up with you because you're already up. Anyway, let's keep going. So when you break things down into smaller pieces, right, it doesn't have to be a big step. Just something small to get the ball rolling. Then once you've completed that task, identify the next thing you can do, right? You get it. One step at a time leads to miles of greatness. By taking that one step at a time, you'll start to build momentum and gain confidence in your ability to move forward. Because some of the greatest problems that we have, the stumbles, is that we're stumbling over our lack of knowledge or a lack of, wait, we just didn't take that next step. And we think we have to see everything and know everything all at once. You don't. For me, get in the car right now, and then we go for a drive on the island. Now let's go reminisce. Let's go where I went to high school, where I grew up. What does that look like? What does it look like now? It's pretty incredible to go back, but you see, I would never get to that if I didn't get in the car. There's the starting point. Then what's the next thing? Oh, maybe, where do I want to go? Great question. Answer that. Put it in the GPS. Great. Now, you see what I mean? Now, I know that seems really strange, but sometimes we just have to be so specific and take one step at a time. Number three, get outside your comfort zone. You've heard this, I know, a million times over. But sometimes when you're just feeling stuck or feeling lost, it's a sign that you're in a rut. You may need to break out of your comfort zone and try something new. And it doesn't have to be crazy. Go eat a new dish at a restaurant for the first time. That's very simple. Go try a new drink, right? It might be taking a class or joining a club or volunteering for something, a cause that you care about. But by trying new things, you'll gain new experiences and perspectives, and you may discover a new passion or direction in life. So it's kind of a win-win all the way around. Number four, seek advice and support. You don't have to figure out things all by yourself. That feeling of being alone, sometimes we do it to ourselves because of the choices that we make. So seek advice and support from people you trust, whether that's a mentor, a coach, a friend, maybe it's a family member. They might be able to offer you guidance and insight that you hadn't really considered, right? It's a different peek into your life. And just having someone talk to you, honestly, right, can be incredibly beneficial when you're feeling lost and unsure. And a lot of times, we're just trying to have somebody say, I hear you, yes, and then repeat something back to us. So it's not like they have to be a rocket scientist to help us, right? They just need to listen so we can hear our own thoughts. So go out and seek advice and support with the right people. I must emphasize that, because sometimes we are seeking advice and support from the wrong people, and you know exactly what I'm talking about. And finally, number five, give yourself permission to make mistakes. How many mistakes have I already made today in talking to you on this episode? I know you're giving me grace, and I appreciate that. You know, my schedule is out of the routine, but you see, just because my schedule is out of the routine doesn't mean I still can't be here to serve you. I can give you my thoughts. They may not be perfected, but guess what? They are my thoughts, and I'm showing up every day because, well, that's what I do, and that's important to me, because guess what you need to do in your life? You need to show up every day, and in order to do that well, you got to give yourself permission to make mistakes. It's all right to have those failures and missteps, and you can learn and grow from them. And when you do stumble, don't be too hard on yourself, especially if they don't go as planned. Just do a roundabout. Sometimes you need to do a couple circles to see the beauty of Diamond Head. So are you feeling lost or unsure about what to do next? Because if you are, I know it's challenging. But remember, you're not alone. You can regain your sense of direction and move forward with confidence. Yep, that may mean you got to check your panties. Oh, wait, that's for another episode. That means you got to put your big girl panties on. Seriously. We can't sit here and think, maybe today, maybe not. Oh, maybe so. No, you just go. A lot of times a way to accomplish that is to get out of your own head and go out and do. Sometimes you need to jump, no matter how high it seems. Life will never be what you think it should be, so don't overthink what you can overcome. My prayer for you is may your thoughts generate the ideas to go beyond your limiting beliefs. Allow your actions to be the moments and the movement you need to keep the ball rolling. One step at a time leads to your miles of greatness. Go out, be present, be incredible, be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious, blessed day. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.